Hello, I am Seamus Donohue of EVE University, and this is episode 12 of How to Survive EVE Online. In this episode, we are going to take on the second step of the business chain. So, go to Neocom, Journal, look for Balancing the Books 2 of 10, right-click, and start conversation with Loic de Mencier. And Loic de Mencier wants to find the remains of some ship and use a salvaging module on it. And if we come across any Serpentis pirates, kill them. So, let's accept the mission, and the agent is going to give us a unit of civilian salvager. You will need a salvaging module of some kind to finish the mission, though the mission recognizes that you might not have salvaging trained up yet. So, let's go to the fitting window. We'll need a weapon, but we won't need a mining laser. So, let's take off the mining laser, let's put on the civilian salvager. Oh, for reference, it's been several hours since I did the last episode, so some skills have finished training up, but I still can't inject the salvaging skill yet. I should be able to use an expanded cargo hold. Actually, you know what? I'm not expecting all that much cargo, so I'm probably not going to need that. And you know what? I might have finished training afterburners by this point. Yes, I trained afterburners level 1. You know what? Just because I feel like it, I'm going to buy an afterburner 1. And here's the cheapest one in station. A little bit pricey, but it is only about 12,000 ISK. So we'll slap that on. Alright, I think I am ready. So, let's undock. Alright, let's click next on the built-in tutorial. Let's get that out of the way. Right-click, balancing the books, objective. What's going on here? Why can I not warp to it? I cannot warp to it because it is not in the solar system. Right! Let's fix that problem. Right-click the destination where it says location Ecuenbaron, or whatever solar system it is in your case, set destination. Right-click Clemelon. Add waypoint, and let's reverse the distance sort, left click the stargate, and click warp.
Warp drive active.
All of the career funnel systems have one thing in common, they are dead-end systems, they've only got one stargate. Remember, you want to warp to zero on the gate, don't let the autopilot fly your ship. Now, as long as we are traveling to the destination system, I'm going to point out a couple of things that I may not have mentioned. First of all, your ship has something called a capacitor. And a capacitor is basically an energy pool that your modules all draw from. The capacitor recharges slowly from an invisible power plant in the background that the game does not explicitly model. But it charges your capacitor over time. But it doesn't charge it at an even rate. The capacitor recharges fastest when it's at 25% and slower at any other point. So the modules that you have attached to your ship, they all need capacitor energy. The armor repair, in particular, it uses 40 gigajoules every 5.1 seconds. The afterburner, which is a module which increases the sublight speed of your ship, needs 20 gigajoules every 11 seconds. If you get the salvager module running... Hold on, we're actually in Ecuenbaron. Let's right-click, agent missions, balancing the books, encounter, warp to location.
Warp drive active.
Hybrid and laser turrets also use capacitor, though projectile turrets and missiles do not. and your weapon needs about a gigajoule every 2 seconds. All of these things take capacitor energy, and if your capacitor is empty, then any module you're trying to keep running is just going to shut down. It's going to become inactive, I should say. It won't, technically speaking, go offline. So in the early part of the tutorials, when Aura was telling you only use your armor repair when you need to, well, that's why. You don't have enough power generation to run the armor repair module all the time, and according to the fitting window, you don't have enough power to run all of these modules at once, so you should only turn on your modules when you need to. It is possible through rigs, modules, and skills to increase your capacitor generation rate. That is why I had you inject the skills Energy Systems Operation and Energy Management. Those skills help increase your capacitor recharge rate. Anyway, enough talking, we are at the acceleration gate. Left click the acceleration gate, left click activate gate,
warp drive active.
And we will head on into the mission. Let's bring the closest objects to the top of the overview and approach the civilian transport ship. And let's lock that transport and let's lock the pirate. And let's turn on the afterburner just to go a little faster. And turn it off again because that thing is not all that far away. Once you're within 5 kilometers, hit F2 on your left click the target portrait for the civilian transport ship. Then hit F2 to activate the civilian salvager. And you will start trying to salvage the civilian transport ship. Left click the Serpentis Rookie. Hit F1 to start firing your weapon. Alright, so much for the Serpentis. Now, you're probably going to go through a lot of failed cycles. While you're trying to work on... Oh, you successfully accessed the civilian transport shipwreck. Okay, good. Left-click the civilian transport shipwreck. It could either be the target portrait, or the bracket, or the entry in the overview. Any one of those three works. And left-click open cargo. This is your mission objective. Drag the black box from here to your ship's cargo hold. Now, this wreck icon indicates that there is loot on it, and it's less than 2.5 kilometers away. So you left-click the wreck, open cargo, and you grab the loot. Click and drag. We don't have the real salvaging skill. We're just using a civilian salvager to do the mission. You can't use a civilian salvager on a real wreck. All right, you need a real salvager. So let's head back to Clelanon. Left-click the Stargate, and warp. And let's hit Control-R just to be in the habit of reloading our weapons when we get a chance. I forgot to mention, if you are playing an Amarian character and you're using lasers, or if you're playing any character who is using lasers, really, your frequency crystals do not need to be reloaded. The normal frequency crystals do not need to be replenished. Fancier versions of the frequency crystals, for example, I think it's the Amar Navy Standard S, for example. I'd have to look it up. Faction frequency crystals and other kinds of fancy frequency crystals will eventually shatter. But the regular ones, the ones that just say Radio S or Standard S or Multi-Frequency S, those don't need to be replenished. Unless your ship exploded and the crystals exploded with it.
Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
We are back in station. Let's drag the loot to the station item hangar, right-click Loic Tmentsier because I happen to remember who's the agent I'm working for. If you don't happen to remember, you can go to Neocom, Journal, look for the mission that's accepted, right-click, and start conversation. Everything is green check marks, so complete the mission, and he gives us another Navitas frigate and 149,000 credits. In the next episode, we will take on the next step of the business chain. In the meantime, thank you for watching.